You see, there are three kinds of doshas, defects. Manasika dosha, sharirika dosha, and vak dosha. So Patanjali, okay, this has come, I mean, it is inherited by us from earlier great people. Patanjali authored three works to see that all the three kinds of defects people are suffering from are corrected actually. They won't, they will get rid of these defects, people. What he did for Manasika Dosha, he authored Yoganushasana. Okay. Patanjali authored Yoganushasana in order to see that the people get rid of the defects related to Manas. Manas is more important than Shariram. So, first we are discussing Manas. Although someone takes some medicine or something like that, if the mind, if he doesn't have peace of mind, Manas Shanti, Chitta Shanti, no, that medicine does not work. Very recently, just for the last 25 to 30 years, this modern medicine, English medicine, has been saying this thing. First, you should not have any, tension, etc. in the mind, then only this will be possible. Otherwise, although I give you medicine, injection, etc., if you do not have peace of mind, if you have tension, if you have some sort of a problem, then no, this medicine doesn't work. Recently, these people are saying, very recently. That means, earlier they were talking only about Shariram, not Manas. Isn't it? Anyway, so, second one is, Sharirika Dosha, defects of the body. Due to Desha, you may live in a cold country, you may live in a tropical country, there may be some problem of health. Kala, during winter, there will be less digestive power. During summer, there will be more digestive power. Okay, Desha, Kala, and Patra. Patra is dish. What are you eating? This is very important. You cannot just go on eating something or the other. No. Is it suitable? Pathyesati gadarthasya kimoshatha nishayavanam. One book, Lolam Rajiyam, says, gadarthasya gada means disease. A person is suffering from some disease. Pathyesati, one follows pathya. Pathya means, what does it mean? Not restriction simply, but something that is suitable to his body. Okay, in Shiksha classes, we will discuss this Vata Pitta Kapha Ayurveda, then it will become clearer. Some people have got the nature of Vata. Vata is gas actually. Pitta Paichyam, bilious nature, some people have got that. Suppose if somebody has got bilious nature, he should not eat anything made of oil in the early in the morning, or better to reduce oil, etc. And also this Vartakam or Brinjal, or coconut, etc. like that. Okay. Some people have Vata, Pitta, Kapha. Kapha is a plant, Shleshma. Those people should reduce things which are sweet in nature. One should not stop altogether. I do not eat salt, I take less salt. I do not eat sweet, I take less sweet. No. This is absolutely meaningless. Because Sushruta Samhita, Sushruta says, till the end of your life, all the six tastes you should consume. Otherwise, what will happen? There is one thing called Ojahakshaya. Recently, people call it AIDS, acquired Indian tuber. So, Ojahakshaya, if one gets, Ojas is the cause of balam, strength. Ojo balam, this is in Veda, Krishna Yajurveda. So, Ojas is the cause of strength, balam. So if you reduce you may reduce depending on the health position. Okay, but totally avoiding either salt or sweet or something like that, anything the like, no, that would lead to this problem. That is Ojahakshaya. If one is suffering from Ojahakshaya, what will happen? Then somebody is just having the cold, common cold in Himalayas, and this person also gets it. Although if you are at a far away place, it is likely that people, I mean, you will just get the diseases easily. That means there will be less and less resistance in the body. Therefore, one should not give up any taste of 6 tastes are there, you know. That is one. So, pachesati gadarthasya, when he follows the suitable food, etc., and also hitam bhunyat, mitam bhunyat, na bhunyat, amitam hitam, Ayurveda. Whatever is suitable to your body, you eat it. Mitam bhunyat, take the food, whatever it may be, in a limited quantity. Mitam bhunyat, na bhunyat, amitam hitam. Although you like it, although it is suitable to your body, you should not take too much of it. What is the general sutram? Ati sarvatra vajjayet. Ati, reading too much, working on computer too much, eating too much, walking too much, everything. Ati sarvatra vajjayet is the general rule. If anybody asks you, tells you to come and do this and that thing, walking too much, some people go on, walk 5 kilometers, 10 kilometers. Hey, why are you walking so much? No. Be in your limits. That's so, pachyasati gadarthasya kim aushadhi nishevanam. Why to take medicines? When you follow the proper food, the other sentence is just like that with sandhi. Pachye asati, pachye asati, pachye after pachye, there is one called avagraha, like this kind of mark. Pachye asati, when one does not follow the proper food, etc., gadarthasya, he got some disease, kimaushadhi nishevanam, why to take medicine? So if you follow the pachyam, then also it is a waste. Medicine is not required. If you do not follow pachyam, then also medicine is not required. How beautifully they say. In Sanskrit Vyakaranam, you have Kaumudi yadi kanthastha pratha bhashye parishrama. If you have studied Kaumudi well, then it is not needed. Mahavashyam need not be studied. Kaumudi yadi akanthastha, if Kaumudi is not there on the tip of your tongue, Prathabhashya parishrama, then it is a waste of time to study Mahabhashya. Ah, you see, the chamatkara, how to speak, we have to learn. Okay, so now that is about Shariraka doshas. The third one is Vak doshas. Actually, what is this Vak dosha? Because it is only in Indian culture, not in other cultures. Why is it not there? We don't know. Here there has been a Vedic Sampradaya, it is very, very systematic. So Mlecha, what do you mean by Mlecha? Mlecha means Aspashta Bhashana. This Sanskrit way, Vilkinda Nama, very clearly he was speaking. These people say, what's your name? What is your name? Where are you going? Where are you going? So these Sanskrit people, whose mother tongue was Sanskrit, they used it to say to each other, Kimayam lechati? What this person is saying something unclearly? What does it mean? What he wants, etc., etc. So here, one has to use the Shabdas in line with the Shiksha Shastra. Shiksha means which tells how to pronounce, etc., etc. So this is very, very clear. So that's why we cannot compare Sanskritam with other languages, which generally we call Mlecha Bhasha. Mlechas are Greek people entered India long, long ago, then came from Persia, presently Iran. I mean, the entire Mediterranean you take, people from there. And later on, these English people, etc., etc., they started changing the names themselves. Mahamayi, Bombay. Dehali means threshold, Dilli, Vishakhapatnam, Vaijab. What happened to you? You cannot pronounce. First thing is, you take such kind of food. Second thing is, you are not trained on these lines. Here, clarity is very important. So, Vagdoshas, in order to see that the people will get rid of the Vagdoshas, Patanjali Adhar, Mahabhashya. Now it is clear, Yoganushasanam for Manasika Doshas, Charaka Sutram for Charyaka Doshas, and Mahabhashyam for Vag Doshas. For means to get rid, like that. Now, they were very, very clear. That means their minds were, first of all, their minds were controlled. Yoga Bhyasa, through yoga abhyasa. In yoga anushasana, these things are discussed. One can see the things that happened in the past, that are there behind the wall, that are going to happen, and that cannot be perceived, seen through ordinary eyes. Otherwise, how come Panini could just prepare, compile one Vyakaranam for both Vaidik Shabdas and Laukik Shabdas? Because Vaidik Shakhas are 1130. They are just one papad as far as Panini is concerned. No. For one branch itself to learn one Shakha, Yajushakha, Rikshakha, etc. Oh, it is very difficult for us, people like us. But for Panini, just like that. So you will find Shabdas from different Veda Shakhas. Okay, it may be Rig Veda, it may be Sama Veda, Atharva Veda, Yajur Veda, etc.